Bitch in a condo cabin, I sleep in my Phantom. Dancing with the stars to the Star Spangled Banner. I change your channel, I change your pattern. I ring your Saturn, I your madam. She get and I shake the ladder. I make her take her, then gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes. I'm on a all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when they came in islands. Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative, I demonstrated this, played it. I don't care if you owe me, you need to pay me. I kiss your lady, then kiss the baby. Get situated, get keys off table and leave her. I really made it, get it made. Won't wrestle, cause I spatula all you action figures.
These tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls, they say, yeah.
I'm doing this for L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told you did like a Chevy. I want a Ferrari in yellow. Just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got more bars than a penitentiary. I got a that hang several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features one of the more dangerous pass rushes. The Cardinals lead the league in sacks, and they'll be up against a Falcons team that will need to try and keep that pass rush off balance. With that, let's get out to the University of Phoenix Stadium in Glendale. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. It hosted Super Bowls 42 and 49. And it's University of Phoenix Stadium. That's where we're at in Glendale, Arizona. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Atlanta Falcons and the Arizona Cardinals. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. And they'll get it all the way out near midfield to the 45. Good use of the pass there to pick up the first down against a defensive look that they had specifically prepared for, they told us, coming into this one.
Certainly seems like they're holding all the right cards now, doesn't it? Because of their preparation. went back, watched the tape, studied the tendencies, and they feel like they had them down cold, and they were able to use the pass against them.
And the D looking like they may blitz. Now a play fake here on first down. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. And here's a look at the starting offense. Ten yards still left on second down. And they'll go on the ground. And he stopped immediately there. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. And here are the defensive starters, and their coordinator is hoping that they have short-term memories from last week.
A very tough week indeed, Brandon. All they want to do now is be solid right out of the gate. No big plays given up early.
So still a full 10 yards to go here for the offense on third down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. A bullet throw, but incomplete.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Here comes the Cardinals punter now. As the first drive of the game stalls out, he's on to punt. Too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. They'll look to throw here on first down. They'll roll him out right. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
Good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain that time, and it leaves them with third and 11 coming up. And the offense on the field for the first time today, and they were high-powered a week ago.
And they're beginning to believe that they've established a groove. They expect those type of performances each and every week. Running it, throwing it, they're precise. Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. Back to throw here. And this is going to be incomplete.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
The Falcons send out their punter as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
And here are the defensive starters. In your old position, you get to talk about the secondary.
The best athletes on the field, Brandon.
Ah, debatable.
Well, we'll see how this goes today. I love the way you put my guys down. But you know this, they've got to cover and they have to tackle. They have a heck of a task in front of them in this game.
And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
They'll come out in the pistol.
Let's go! Green, 39!
And they'll run it here. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a third and seven.
Now, that result is no surprise. This team is bringing back memories of what? The 85 Bears, the 2000 Ravens. Those teams were so great against the run, they made you abandon any plans of doing that when you played against them.
The play clock's running down. He'll look to throw. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. A gain of 19 and picking up the first.
The goal of every offense is to move the chains, pick up first downs. A nice job finding an open receiver for a completion.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
The insistence of speed at every position is really seen at the defensive end spot. These guys in the old days were often outside linebackers, and they just pushed them forward because they wanted to play fast and get to the quarterback or the running backs quicker than ever before.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Pick up of 14 yards and it moves the sticks. When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Let's go!
They'll drop to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 11 yards on the pick. Cardinals a first down. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone.
Let's go! Green! Gone!
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. This will be caught inside the 10. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives them a first and goal.
Looked like defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
All right, here we go.
They'll look to throw here. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out here in the eye. And here we go on first and goal. And they'll go with a ground attack here. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number 1 against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. And now out is the Cardinal field goal team here. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. And his kick is right there. It's good. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
It's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up 2nd and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Let's go!
Looking to throw. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make it 3rd down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot. Because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. But he's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there you might out of a smaller back. They'll send the big tight end in motion right. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Well, partner, they might want to tear up their scouting reports a little bit here because they just broke tendency. 3rd down, you don't ordinarily see a toss. They ran it, and they ran it really well and picked up the 1st down. I love the way the edges were sealed, which allowed him to get to the corner.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Go!
A give to the fullback on the dive. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Good solid gain on first down, about what you'd expect from the big guy carrying the ball.
They'll come out in the pistol.
Here we go now. 3-19. 3-19. All right, now. Look at 56.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gain, they can run that play on any down.
They go play action here on first down. Wide open receiver complete. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a play fake here on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. And now we'll get a stoppage here. There appears to be an injured Falcon on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. Goal from the 8. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. A great effort there. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Falcons have taken the lead. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. And now a whistle and a timeout called by the kicking team. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for. And take it. And the Cardinals offense here ready to take over. They'll try and start this drive in the air. He sets to fire deep. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect.
Well, I guess we just discovered that someone is certainly not going to sit back and just take it in this game, huh?
No, they were trying to get that touchdown back in one shot.
One shot, trying to help out his defense and let the other team know they were coming after him.
Yardage here. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
All right, partner. Despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So they're behind the chains as the offense. 12 yards needed on third down. They come out here in the eye.
No. Check. Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Taken in at the 22. Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask, 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's brought down. All weekend practice, they stretch grounding, pounding the football, and they really executed it well there to get the first down.
That usually means getting back to being physical in practice, because when you emphasize pounding the football, it doesn't really come together unless you practice it the same way you're going to play it in the game. That means more bodies, more pads, and a whole lot of popping last week, and they got it done in the game.
They'll look to throw here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And now we're circling here around the two-minute warning.
This is a setup play, trying to get one last one in before the clock warning.
And he'll go on the ground. Fighting him off.
Just ran right through the trash.
There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Falcons. A great play there. Touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Falcons will add on to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. So out now come the Cardinals. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And now here's a carry heading left. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
Yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. All day. All right, here we go. Boom!
He'll drop to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. and short. They'll try and pick it up through the air. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
They were full-scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And some extras coming up on the line here, readying for the blitz. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Sliding out of the pocket. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
It's always tough trying to keep your guy upright when he's trying to throw the football. When you're dealing with those big, bad guys on the defensive front, it's even tougher. And this time, those guys on the opposite side won the battle, getting to the quarterback and knocking him into an incompletion.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. So 3rd and 20, defense in the nickel.
Surprised they didn't go with 6 DBs, the dime look.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here comes the Cardinals punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And possession will change here with very little time remaining until halftime. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Looking deep downfield and almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be 2nd down.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
They'll run it now out of the gun. He finds some open field here. He's at the 40, the 20, and he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again.
and again.
It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
So we reach halftime. Yeah, that's perfect. 2. Davis. Deep. Hank, I gotta go. Okay, and sorry about that. Didn't know Larry got cut off early. We are back and ready for the 3rd quarter. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They built a good first-half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spend the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Another good run there, and now we're seeing an offense that's imposed its will on a defense. When we talk about that all the time, what does it really mean? It means that the guys on the offensive line, they feel like they can do whatever they want. They're in the huddle saying, run it again. Give us another chance to smack someone and create some space. On the defensive side of the ball, not only have they imposed their will against you, you're almost powerless to figure out what you're doing there, but you got to keep your spirit up at the same time, and they're taking that too.
And on second and 10 now. Another pistol look here. And to give this time to the tailback. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him three on the play, and that'll bring up a third down.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end-of-the-half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. He's got a man that's caught left sideline. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Everything about that play was beautiful. A great corner route where the receiver worked the defensive back inside and then broke back to the outside to the corner. But how about the throw by the quarterback? Anticipation on the break from inside to outside. He threw the football as the receiver turned around. The ball greeted him.
And a quick throw here. That's complete. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Left for the offense. It's second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game. And while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
They'll throw. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down. So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. This one from 48 yards away.
I know ultimately that feels like a good defensive play, but I know it's really not. They had a chance to keep points off the board. Now they have a chance to kick a field goal by missing that shot.
Yeah, especially at this spot in the field. He's got to be upset he couldn't come up with that INT. And they'll run it here. And he's got room. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
So it'll be first down here after the run. They'll drop to throw. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. And they're going to speed things up here. Through the contact. Incomplete. Well, I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter. As he'll go for it on fourth down. They'll look to throw here. Backing up. Being chased out left. He can run for it, and he will. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. So certainly not what they were hoping for, especially on the road. Their starter forced to the locker room. And they'll turn things over here to the backup to see if he can dig him out of this hole. Oh, a design run for their wideout. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. And they're going to hurry back to the line now.
Even though positive yardage was gained on that play, I think the defense has to be happy. Obviously, they were prepared for some trick plays coming into the game.
And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Their big tight end. His first touchdown on the year. And the Cardinals get a bit closer. Point after try forthcoming. It's up and good, and the lead is down now at 11. It's 21-10. The Cardinals set now to kick this one away, and off we go. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Falcons offense, they get... ready to head back out here. Now, they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team, because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay. So the defense flinches, contact made, and the 5-yard penalty ensues. Running back, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They come out here in the eye. And on the ground they go with the running back. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Let's go!
And to give this time to the tailback. And the cutback to the sideline. Touchdown, Falcons! A big play there with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Falcons will extend their lead. And they drew up the counter there. It worked. They're glad they drew up the counter.
And a lot of times what you're trying to do is just simply get the defense moving in one direction. It doesn't take much, even one step's enough. Get them going in one direction and then cut back against the grain and let your running back finish it off and get the work done.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. They go play action here on 1st down. And a loose football. Give him a couple on the catch. It's 2nd and 8. So the offense avoids disaster, keeps possession. Now it's 2nd down. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
Third down now following the completed pass.
Here we go. White 90.
He'll look to throw. And incomplete here on third down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down.
Let's go. White 90.
White 42. Check 42.
Let's go, D.
Ohio. Check Ohio.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Oh, the ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line. And the Falcons now making their way back out onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Well, they'll take that every time with a lead, first down, fourth quarter, getting 8 yards. You love that.
They will take it, and you have to ask the defensive guys, why did you give it? I mean, you know the situation. You're down, have to stop them, have to get the football back. But 8 yards on first down puts them back on their heels.
Back to throw. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but it doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
Give them 11 on the gain there, and it'll be first down Atlanta.
How about the timing on that one? Boy, they were in sync, weren't they? Three-step drop, balls out of his hands, right to the tight end. Nice completion, just like they do it in practice.
They come out here in the eye. On first down, he'll drop to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. They'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go. Quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down. And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that will stretch the lead up to 3 touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game. So a miss on his first attempt, but this time he gets back on the bike and knocks it home.
I know this will surprise you a little bit, Brandon, but you know, kickers can be a fragile breed sometimes. You gotta wonder what's going through his mind, but he didn't let that first miss impact him one bit.
Hey, I kicked back at Harrison High School. Are you calling my ilk soft? Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
But they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
All right, here we go.
They'll send a receiver in motion left. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Now they'll run it on the toss. Shreds the tackle. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. There, his 25th touchdown, tying him at Smith for the 5th most in one season. And the Falcons turn that interception into a touchdown. And his kick is good. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Let's go!
And he'll give it here to his running back. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of 3, second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
They come out here in the eye, and they'll go on the ground. And some room to work. Cuts back, left sideline. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. They'll give it to him right up the gut. Down to about the 22 here. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's 2nd and 2. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A great play there. His 25th touchdown, tying him at Smith for the 5th most in one season. And the Cardinals cut into that lead. Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And that'll cut the lead back now to 21. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. The Cardinals set now to kick this one away, and off we go. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the upmen. And they're going to be set up in excellent field position up past the 45. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They have the big cushion here in the final stages of this one. I don't know if there's any better feeling than being up big on the road.
There really can't be, because for a team to go on the road and win in the NFL, that's huge to begin with. But just think about all the preparation that went into it. When they first started talking about this game, leading up to it during the week, going on the road, unfamiliar city, obviously, unfamiliar hotel. No one's going to be with you once you get to the stadium. They're all going to be against you. You name it, all those things they had to deal with, they were able to conquer them and do it convincingly.
Yeah, they did it very convincingly, and now the final moments of this one. Now they'll run it on the toss, and he'll get the... Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Running back. And now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
So, Brandon, when this offense gathers together to watch tape for this game, they're going to be feeling pretty good about themselves until the coaches get upset about the play we just saw. But you know their defense is going to be, but we put up big points all game long. The defense is going to win one every now and then.
No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. They'll look to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And it'll be a turnover on downs. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. Just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Going to give this time to the tailback. And down inside the 15 he goes. 13 yards there on the pickup, and it's good enough for an Arizona first.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now, and this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
A gain of six there on first. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen it.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. They come out here in the eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut, and he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. And quickly, they get to the line. First and goal, defense with a... And he is in for six. Touchdown, Cardinals. A great effort there. His 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the fourth most in a single season. And the Cardinals get a bit closer. So time definitely not in their favor. Down two scores, but they'll try the onside kick. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Well, Charles, there's an old saying, don't let a loss beat you twice.
You're exactly right about that, Brandon. When you...